at Moorville. Just catching up again with the mowing and strimming. Got something a bit cooler this week, and we've had some low temperatures at night. Grass has been a bit slower this week. We haven't had much rain yet. We were promised some rain, but it didn't really come. I'm going to get a mic. It's on order. It still hasn't arrived yet, though, so hopefully that'll improve the sound. Okay, especially outdoors, anyway. Right, enjoy the footage from today. Where am I looking? Enjoy the footage. I hope you like it. This is the frame yard, as we call it now. Was just a bonfire yard. It was actually a pig start, like a compound for pigs, I think, at one point. Or perhaps a kitchen garden. This garage is fairly modern. Obviously, polytunnel's modern. We've sort of used it as a back, like a storage and work area. We put, you know, keep our agapanthus over winter, and some of the orange trees go in the polytunnel. And eventually, when the tulips have gone out from the yard, the agapanthus go outside, and then we bring the dahlias out from the cellar to bring them on in here. And we've got some veg on the go as well this year, because we're all trying to grow some food. So that's our starters. We're going to have a load of tomatoes in here, and we've got the chestnut tree, the horse chestnut, which is in flower at the minute. That's a massive horse chestnut tree, looming over everything, shading up the whole place. There's plenty of light despite that. And then here we go, the frames, which are frames I made about, I suppose, they must be 3 years old now, perhaps. Actually, quite large frames, just made of rough sawn timber, fencing timber, with some acrylic tops, raspberries, gooseberries. Oh, but they're coming on now. There we go. Currants. Black currants. These are the orange trees, which would usually be around the canal. At this time, the greenhouse as well. This is another lot of stuff which would usually be out by now, I think. We should probably be getting those out next week, I think. They usually go towards the back of the side garden, behind the ivy arches. And then this is where I'm working today. This is the actual current bonfire yard, where we burn all that stuff, and we just, I mean, really anything that's just too bulky to, too wet and horrible to burn, or, you know, we spread it out here. We've been building up this ground level for a while now, because it was actually really sort of boggy around there. Some geese there. Canada geese there with their babies. Just about to see through the trees. Great. And then this area really has never been anything apart from just a path. But recently we've created some leaf mould bays, leaf litter. And this is the clippings from the yew hedge. Some of the clippings from the yew hedge, some of that's rotted down. That's the stuff from last year underneath, which just broke down. I mean, not all of the stuff, because some of it we spread out on the garden on top of ground fabric to suppress ground alder in areas where it's grown out. And then this this is basically the edge of the property. Well, sort of, that's into the neighbour's garden there. So I've been tidying all this up, which has been mismanaged really, just because nobody has really been in charge of it. All these plants from home, I'm going to stick them in the polytunnel. A few things going on in here. Beans, salads, tomatoes, peppers, peas, courgettes. Alec, I know you'll like to see this, the rose, the Michael's Rose, as you call it, which I know it's not called Michael's Rose. It begins with an M though, I think. In good for flower.